Hi everyone, we're gonna create this really great looking rotating glow effect around the button in this framer tutorial. You're gonna be able to apply the technique also to larger elements like these cards after learning it. I've learned this trick while checking this awesome template Dramosa. You can find the preview link in the description below. So let's get started. Let's create the button first. I will create the text that says button and change its color to lightest from the color styles. And since this effect looks better on big buttons, I will make it size 22 and font weight bold. Then I will wrap it in a stack and name it button. And I'm gonna make its width fit content, then center it to the page. Next, I need to make its top and bottom paddings 16 and left and right paddings 32 pixels. Then I'm going to add a fill to it under the gradient tab. I'm gonna add two color stops with mid blue from the styles. Then I'm gonna add another color stop between them, closer to the left one, and I'm gonna set it to mid blue too. Of course, I'm gonna make sure that its opacity is set to 100%. Lastly, as button style, I will make its radius 8 pixels. Time to create the glow frame with gradient that we're going to rotate to create the glow animation. In order to achieve the effect we want, which is the seamless rotation of a glowing stroke without any cutoffs, the glow frame needs to be big enough. Also, since it's gonna have a conic gradient that grows from the center until a certain value, its size is gonna determine the length of the glow effect, right? So for this button size, having 250 pixels of width and height is optimal, so I will create a frame, make its width and height 250 pixels. Now we can create its gradient, which is gonna have the main element for the glow effect. So I will click its fill and select conic gradient tab, the second one from the right. Then I'm going to make both color stops opacity 0. Since we want a gradient to transparency, and add a color stop to the middle and make its color turquoise from the styles. Then I will drag left and right color stops closer to the middle one, like 40% and 60% mark of the gradient bar. Basically, the cone should cover the bottom edge of the glow frame. As we need the glow gradient to be limited as a 2-pixel stroke, we need to mask it. And we're gonna do it by wrapping the button in a stack that has 2 pixels padding. So I will wrap a button in a stack and name it button wrap. Make its width fit content. I'm gonna horizontally center it. And I will add a 2 pixels of padding. Then I will drag glow frame, actually let's rename this as glow. I will drag glow frame inside of the button wrap, make its position absolute. To center it comfortably, I will make button wrap's overflow visible. Center it to button and make button wrap's overflow hidden again. And I need to add a z-index to button. And make it 8. As you see, our glove looks exactly the way we want, right? Now, all we need to do is adding a rotate loop to the glove. So after selecting it, I'll click effects and select loop. We already have a rotation set to 360 here, so all we need to change is the time of the animation. I will enter 3 seconds for it. Now we can preview our glow animation. and it looks great. But as I see it, we need to make also button wraps corners around it. So I'm gonna select the button wrap stack and I'm gonna add 10 pixels of roundness, buttons roundness plus 2 pixels of padding, and let's preview it again. And it looks perfect now. Now I will create a semi-transparent version of the button to create a more intense glow effect. So I will duplicate the button wrap, move it to side. Then all I need to do is selecting the button stack, clicking its fill box, and making the second color stop's opacity 20%. Now we can preview. And this is certainly a more intense version of the glow effect, right? Which can be used for some main CTAs, like the primary and or biggest ones, that directly affects the conversion. As you can see at the completed page, I also applied this technique to this testimonial card, which I added from the framer assets and changed its colors to show how it looks on large areas. The only difference is, since the rotation covers a bigger area, to achieve the same effect, I needed to slow down the rotate animation by increasing the time to 8 seconds. And of course, the glow frame is bigger. I hope you liked this quick tutorial. If you want to see more, be sure to subscribe, turn the notifications on, and check my other tutorials. So, see you in the next one.